Humanoid Nation. Now to the wrestling talk. Jason is here as usual.
Yep.
So, talking shit, let's talk the shit about wrestling.
We'll keep it wrestling themed. Okay, Fastlane is tomorrow. Have you got your predictions for the card?
Are
you
What's on the card?
Okay,
the triple threat. Like, that's so predictable. Fuck. What it is, Dean Ambrose, Brock Lesnar, Roman Reigns. Okay, who's going to win that? Obviously, Roman Reigns, the Superman Samoan guy, because they're making him the Samoan John Cena now. Because they got that set for Triple H versus Roman Reigns at WrestleMania. Oh, God, that match is going to be horrible.
How many times have they done the Authority versus the Rebellious Figure thing in wrestling?
Too many times. They did it right. They did it awesomely with the Corporation versus the Stone Cold. That was awesome. But this is just a rehash. It's kind of boring, but yeah, it's still.
You see, this is how, when I was coming up in the Attitude Era, maybe it's because it was the era we came up in for wrestling.
Yeah.
I thought wrestling always had originality and that they never did things twice. Tyler Breeze, which I'm sure if wrestling fans are watching this,
most likely they are because it is Inside the Ropes we're doing now.
You know, his
Inside the Ring. I forgot the name of my own show.
Okay, that's just one. Okay, that's.
But they know
you're
me.
You're having a bad day. But,
no, that's just basing me all the time. They know how I am.
Well, you'll probably have the fancy, dancy intro banners to start this off or something. So right there, it'll tell them what the show is.
Yeah, like I know. Still, but anyway, Tyler Breeze. He's like what is?
He's an homage to Gorgeous George. A throwback of...
Way to go old school there.
1930s, so... Yeah. You probably didn't know that, I assume, so.
Well, I kind of assume I kind of forgot it was Gorgeous George, but he does resemble.
Because he watched a lot of old school tapes, Tyler Breeze, so
yeah.
He gets inspiration.
Too bad Vince McMahon doesn't like him, because Tyler Breeze, as a talented motherfucker, Vince doesn't like him, so he de-pushed his push, which is a shame.
He, it looks like he's kind of become the modern-day average. He seems to be doing jobs left and right, like... They had a five-way Intercontinental title match last Monday on Raw.
Yeah, you can't take Tyler Breeze seriously on the main roster. Right now, whenever you see him, you're like, oh, fuck, here comes Tyler Breeze.
Should we mention the Ascension?
Because, when you saw him on NXT, you're like, oh, shit, Tyler Breeze is coming out. This is going to be good. Now he's on Raw, you're like, oh, fuck, Tyler Breeze is coming out. This is going to be shit.
Like, look at the Ascension.
Exactly, the Ascension.
They were unstoppable on NXT, and now they're the job... The modern-day job team of the main roster tag team division. So it's like you've told me 1,000 times, you cannot take what you see in NXT and parallel that to the main roster because it is most likely not going to be the same thing because the guy in charge of the main roster does not see things the same way that Triple H does.
Right. Because NXT, in my opinion, is like a mini ROH, which is awesome. Ring of Honor. Because you got to see actually wrestling on that show. Then the main roster is full of entertainment and bullshit and story and drama and shit. And Vince McMahon runs that.
Yeah. It's like I said in my video, I doubt you heard of the Carol Burnett Show.
I heard of it, but I haven't seen. I heard some, seen some episodes.
WWE, especially Raw, reminds me of a modern homage to the Carol Burnett Show with all the variety campy skits they do and crap like that. And it's really quite annoying, you know. When I turn in wrestling, I want to tune in to see guys fighting for championships and to see who's the best, you know? The suspense of disbelief. And that is simple booking 101, but they don't stick to that, do they?
No, because WWE, here's how their booking is. Hey, we have a good idea for an idea. It's let's do this. Oh, man, it makes way too sense. Let's go the opposite direction. Because look, the invasion angle, the perfect... fucking story they could have had. They could have done so many good things. They went the opposite direction. Fuck. And then months later, they got the guys they couldn't afford. Kevin Nash, Scott Hall, Hulk Hogan, Goldberg, Ric Flair. And months after the invasion angle, they couldn't have... Have you not seen What Culture on WWE? The YouTube channel, WWE What Culture?
I didn't know they had a YouTube channel. That's news to me now, but...
No, it's not by WWE. It's this guy named Adam. He does...
No, does he do the website too?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll show check you. That out.
He goes how did WWE should book the invasion? He said how they would have booked it is wait until after WrestleMania, and then when you can actually afford all these guys, do the invasion angle for a year and book it right and all that stuff.
Jim Cornette, Cheap Plug Cornette Experience, one of the better podcasts out there, he's talked about that stuff too with wrestling historians, and they've said the invasion angle, if done correctly, could have been a 2-year storyline.
Exactly.
$20 million profit.
They would have made some cash on that shit. But who do we get? The only big names we got were Booker T and Diamond Dallas Page. No offense to those guys, Diamond Dallas Page is amazing, but when he debuted, he was the stalker, and like, fuck, that went downhill. Booker T was made out to be a fucking joke.
I personally think Booker T should have beat The Rock in their first matchup to create
steam. They killed Booker T's right there at that moment, like when Booker T came out, like talking, all of a sudden, Rock killed him in like the first few seconds. By what did he say? Remember what he said? Who in the blue hell?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. All
credibility went out the window.
And Diamond Dallas Page has talked about it. He wanted to do the People's Champion
versus the People's Champion. I would have loved that. Rock versus DDP. People's Champ versus People's Champ. It's like, it's not a big name, DDP, WCW name, but he was a name, and everybody wanted to see People's Champ versus People's Champ.
And I'm not knocking Christian, but DDP should have had a little bit higher place on the WrestleMania cards, in my opinion.
Yeah, that was a good match, though, him and Christian. They had a good match, yeah, for what it was.
And the NWO, like you as much as any of us love seeing ECW as part of the invasion, but did it kind of, wasn't the emphasis of the invasion WWE or F at the time versus WCW?
It was supposed to be WCW versus WWE, but then they put ECW. You know what? The whole storyline was awesome up until Stephanie McMahon came out, because like, fuck, when ECW came out to say, like, we're in this war, everybody was like shitting their pants, like, holy fuck. And then it kept on going. And
I think Paul Heyman was a consultant or something for the Alliance.
Yeah, right? That was stupid. But then all of it went to shit as soon as Stephanie McMahon came out as the new owner of ECW. I'd be like, fuck.
I think a lot of the shows are...
Nothing says Extreme more than Stephanie McMahon.
A lot of people have said, like, what's it been, 15 years since the invasion angle ended or something like that, more or less?
15 years?
More than 15 years,
wasn't
yeah.
it 2002?
2001. WCW.
Oh yeah,
I think.
Fuck! It's been 15 years.
I think in a month it'll be 15 years since WCW.
That's quite
out.
A long time.
And you know, like a lot of people have said in that 15 years that the WCW invasion turned into as the world like a McMahon family soap opera.
Like it always is, as usual.
Like, you know, did you like it WrestleMania 16 when they had a McMahon in each corner for the main event? For that four-way,
it was decent.
Like, I still don't get Mick Foley retired at No Way Out 2000, right?
Yeah.
I still don't understand if he technically had to be retired, what the hell he was doing on the card in Mania in the first place. But from what I've gathered, it was.
Well, it wasn't supposed to be Mick there. It was originally supposed to be Chris Jericho in the Fatal Four-Way.
Oh, it was.
Yeah, okay. You didn't notice? Oh, okay.
I didn't know that.
Because they have. There's proof out there, like, where they had, like, the original WrestleMania poster.
Oh, okay.
The Fatal 4-Way was Rock, Big Show, Triple H, and Chris Jericho. But somehow, they changed it up into having Mick Foley in there, so they got rid of Chris Jericho.
So, Kurt and Chris Benoit were supposed to have a one-on-one match.
I have no idea. Probably.
You know what that reminds me of? Did you know that Mark Jindrak was originally part of Evolution?
The unaired episode of Evolution. Yes, they did vignettes. The original Evolution vignettes was like Mark Jindrak, Batista, Triple H, and Flair. They had. Go on YouTube, find this shit. We're not lying. There is Mark Jindrak in the original vignettes. It's like they did that shit, then they looked at it. It was like Mark Jindrak looks so out of place in this. And they got rid of him and put Randy Orton in. Imagine Mark Jindrak in Evolution. But then they put Mark Jindrak in Kurt Angle's group, the failed Evolution group that they had in SmackDown.
Mark Jindrak has been technically coined as the guy with no charisma and is just bland and couldn't get over if his life depended on it.
I like his wrestling style, even though it's kind of boring. But like he was part of the...
Marcus Coriolano.
What the hell is that WCW group that he was in? The
Natural Born Thrillers.
Natural Born Thrillers. That was an awesome group.
I heard now he's changed his name to Marcus Coriolano.
Mark Coriolano.
Sounds like Mafia.
It's supposed to be a name off The Godfather.
And he's now denounced himself from American culture, living in Mexico. And have you heard Jim Cornette's rant on Lucha Underground?
What do you say about Lucha Underground? Speaking of Lucha Underground, it's like I know I talked about this before, but you don't see it because like As a guy who does YouTube, I edit sometimes. Y'all know I edit. I put some stuff in
you probably chopped a lot of stuff in your... How many episodes of Inside the Ropes have you done?
I forget. Probably this is 17. I'm not sure.
You probably chopped a lot of stuff, right?
Yeah. Sketches. I do sketches and all that stuff. But when I watch Lucha Underground, the editing in that thing is so goddamn weird. I like it, but it takes me so out of place because they zoom in and shit like a soap opera, like an actual soap opera.
Do you find it weird that they're doing seasons, like a sitcom or a drama?
Well, didn't, what the fuck was it called? That show on MTV a long time ago.
Reality Wrestling?
No, not that one.
That Teddy Hart thing?
XPW?
Wrestling Society X.
Wrestling Society X, that one. They did that, seasons, but it was only lasted one season.
I think that was Eric Bischoff's and Jason Hervey's thing, right?
Eric Bischoff, not real. I don't know, but it was doing it MTV style. But yeah, back to what you were saying. Yeah,
Wrestling Society X. Jim Cornette got a lot of heat because he trashed it and said it's a slap in the face to the wrestling business. It's not real wrestling, and just went on a tirade.
I can see what he's talking about because, like, yeah, like they treat it like just a regular show and stuff.
Basically, it's
they have wrestling in there, but it's just basically a show.
He said the shit is unwatchable, and I guess Triple A, even though they don't pay Rey Mysterio, and my apologies to any of your Mexican viewers, the Lucha wrestling is one of the oldest forms of wrestling out
there.
It's still got quite the following. And, you know, if you trash Lucha Underground, which technically is a spinoff or an offshoot of Triple A, you're going to piss off the Mexican Latino demographic, right?
Yeah,
so,
you are.
You know, the Latino culture is calling for Jim Cornette's head on a stick, basically, because of his Lucha Underground comments, which you should go back and listen. I don't know if you listen to his podcast, but...
I listened to some of his stuff. I still got to catch up on.
Like, his Kenny King thing was just the best.
You might have listened to that, yeah. Kenny King in it for himself.
And you did not know he worked for the Chippendales.
No, I did not know that. For those of you who don't know, Kenny King was a former Chippendale, or still is, who knows.
As Jim Cornette would say, wagging his dick in some guy's face or some shit.
Yeah. Oh, Jim Cornette is always awesome.
But his partner, Rhett Titus, is a talented motherfucker, isn't he?
Yeah.
In the All Night Express.
Yes, he is.
And Ring of Honor, it's not the same Ring of Honor as the old days, is it? It's now ran by a corporation, and Cornette's arguing with Kenny King. Or should we get back to Lucha? Should we continue?
We're talking about wrestling anyways. Like, well, Ring of Honor, like, I like the old school Ring of Honor when they were in a gym, but still, they're still wrestling, still.
No, but his argument is, this guy, apparently the story is, he screwed over Ring of Honor to go to TNA when he was...
And what a trip that was. Look what happened to him in TNA. Didn't do good. TNA!
Beatdown Clan, my friend. Beatdown.
That didn't last long, did it?
I don't even think... I think MVP left TNA, too. I don't even...
He left a long time ago. But speaking of TNA, what the fuck happened to TNA? It was so awesome. Asylum years. My God, it was. They had their bullshit during the Asylum years. Yes, they still had their problems, but not as bad as it is now.
Are you still watching when Awesome Kong beat up Bubba the Love Sponge?
No. When was the last time I stopped watching TNA full time? I think it was when they got
their... When Hogan came in, right?
Before then. Like, when they started, like, making AJ Styles look like a bitch.
Oh, by the way, Suicide, I think, has officially been retired, because the guy that was playing him is now...
TJ Perkins,
I think
left.
He's gone from TNA.
Yeah, he left. TJ Perkins. Puma, Suicide, whatever his name is.
Oh, shit. Oh, God, what's that guy's name? Tiger Mask. There's a dude...
Tiger Mask?
No, not Tiger Mask. Tiger Ego or... Fuck.
Tiger Mask?
No, some Tiger guy in TNA.
Tiger Mask!
No, not Tiger Mask. Tiger Uno or some
crap. Oh, Tigre Uno. What?
I don't even know if he's still... I always liked him.
Tigre Uno is still around. Is he X-Division champ? I don't know who's X-Division champ anymore.
I thought you keep track of all the title history.
I do, but I don't pay attention. Because it's TNA. I write down who's a fucking champion, and then I forget who it is.
Did you know that... I think they do like 2 pay-per-views a year now or something.
They do their like one night only pay-per-views.
Do those still count? Or
yeah, but still,
I don't think they're really in sync with the storylines though.
No, because they're taped way before whatever the fuck happened. So when you start watching it, it doesn't make sense because their storylines are from long ago and they have new storylines now. So what the fuck? Because like you see champions on that show and then there's a different champion on the...
Are you familiar with that? They had that kind of oddity group in TNA. The guy from WWE, he was Nate.
Knox.
Mike Knox. They had that clown, that
Crazy Steve.
He's now teaming with Abyss. Did you know that?
That's a weird tag team. And Abyss is still there. Holy shit.
That's another guy. Would you like to see Abyss in WWE?
I'd like to see... Not really. Because, like... Well, yeah. But what the hell's that group's name? Like, the Clown Society? No, it's not the Clown Society. I'm thinking of the Dead Carnival, but that's Vampiro's group in WCW.
Obviously, they need to fill teams. Beer Money's back together.
For some reason.
What the fuck is up with that, considering...
They're a good tag team, but fuck. Weren't they just feuding?
What was your favorite Beer Money match? Remember when they did the Best of Seven with Machine Guns?
Oh, that was just there was a lot of favorite matches with Beer Money. I just can't pick
them all. And you know what's funny? Wasn't Beer Money a thrown together team originally?
All of them. Yeah, Beer Money was a
thrown. Because James Storm and
Bobby... So was America's Most Wanted.
Oh, yeah. I remember seeing the videos of those... I'm just going to put this here, sorry. Weren't they teamed together as part of, like, the inaugural NWA Tag Team Title Tournament or something like that?
Yeah, during the Sodom days when they were, like, they're doing a Tag Team Title Tournament, they put random tag teams together. And Chris Harris and James Storm clicked, and they became America's Most Wanted.
And then we all think, because we always use that Rockers analogy when teams split up, the Shawn Michaels and the Marty Jannetty of the teams. Didn't we all think Chris Harris was Shawn Michaels?
Yeah, we all thought Chris Harris was a Shawn Michaels and James Storm would flounder. Look what happened. Chris Harris.
Is he even wrestling anymore?
Braden Walker. Who's there?
Yeah.
I'm going to knock your brains out.
How long was Braden Walker in WWE? Like 3 weeks or something? Or?
I have no idea. Did you see that YouTube video of some guy who like...
The Hall of Fame?
No, Braden Walker like... Went, like, it was funny as fuck. Like, Eric Bischoff and somebody was talking on Raw all the time. You hear Braden Walker's music come out, and like you hear JR going nuts.
Oh, I think I saw that.
He was like, "Oh my God, it's Braden Walker!" It was hilarious.
By the way, if we're talking, what's your thoughts on the Total Divas show?
Fucking shit! I seen two episodes. The first two episodes, I never went back to watch it.
Are you a fan of Nikki Bella?
Hell no. Neither am I a fan of Brie Bella. Like,
but you gotta admit, you gotta have sympathy for the poor girl. She broke her freaking neck, man.
Yeah.
She's already back in the gym training.
Same with John Cena. He's back in the gym training. He may be wrestling Undertaker, you know that?
If Cena comes back...
Because, like, the motherfucker is in the gym.
They're having the Vince McMahon... Have you heard about the Vincent J. McMahon Award that they're presenting this Monday on Raw?
The excellence thing?
Something about no one being equal to get it till now. A lot of people are saying, like you're saying, that Cena is going to be that guy that comes out. And
already you're saying Bret Hart or Kurt Angle. But I highly doubt Kurt Angle will show up because, like,
how about Goldberg versus Undertaker? As funny as that sounds, man.
Goldberg. That'd be something. Goldberg, my God. But yeah, reason why I think John Cena is going to show up because, like, he did the same shit years ago when he was injured, showed up at the Royal Rumble, surprising every motherfucker in the
place. So Cena will not be missing his first Mania ever. He'll keep up his Mania streak of 13 in a row.
Feels like he's already in the gym training and shit. So.
He realizes Cena has been on every WrestleMania since 20.
Since his first one. No. Okay, WrestleMania 20 was his first, but the WrestleMania 19 he was not on.
Doesn't count really.
He was on pre-show because he did the rapper gimmick back then. Remember, kids, the rapper gimmick. No, okay, okay.
Didn't Bold Buchanan show up years later on Raw, kind of like where the fuck have you been type thing with Cena?
Yeah, it was like what the fuck, dude? what is this? Bold Buchanan B2. Oh my God.
So Cena really, like. If Cena shows up on Raw...
I'm gonna fucking flip.
Like, when he got injured, did not the wrestling community have a field day with his expense?
Yes, everybody was celebrating. He was like, fuck, John Cena may be out. And now we see pictures of him, like, training in the gym. I go like, oh, fuck, he's doing the Royal Rumble thing again.
What are the chances that AJ Styles could be the guy facing Undertaker?
Highly unlikely.
The Phenomenal One versus the Phenom. Does that not sound
like... I like to see that, but it's highly unlikely.
And, I've told you about that, Chris Morrison guy that does the Aftermath podcast. Yeah. He's the one that brought up that theory. Styles and Taker are wearing the same theme color of tights, man.
Yeah, but think about it this way. Styles is a short guy. Undertaker's huge. Like, it's kind of been uneven.
Shawn Michaels was a short guy, too.
But not as short as AJ.
You make AJ sound like he's a munchkin or something, dude.
Kind of is. I'm no beef towards people that like him. I love AJ Styles, but put him in front of Undertaker, like, what is this?
How high on the card does Vince McMahon view AJ Styles?
I don't know, since he has a lot of beef with him right now. He has a lot of heat, because what did AJ do?
Oh, it's the intellectual rights of signing over. Kevin Steen did this too. They signed with a toy company previously before. Yeah, something so minute like and irrelevant.
Like something so little. Because Vince McMahon wants to own everybody. Yeah.
Corporate greed, my friend. Yeah. Vince McMahon. But that's another topic for another day.
But Kevin Owens versus AJ Styles at WrestleMania, that'd be a good match.
Some people are saying Vince McMahon might be the guy that faces Undertaker.
Why?
Because something to do with they can't think of anyone else is
you know,
Vince
who
part.
Should, you know who should be? Mantor.
How about Batista?
You didn't get the joke, okay.
No, I didn't. I'm sorry. I'm.
Oh, no. Explain. I've been doing a joke for the last couple of months saying, like, oh, it's Mantor. Any time there's a surprise, like, it's Mantor. Bring him back, Mantor. But I guess it's not working.
Wasn't he some type, like, didn't he ever run in ECW 2, Mantor?
He was named something different. I forgot what he was called. He was actually credible. And then he went to WWE. It was called Mantor.
Reminds me of Doink the Clown. How his name is?
Born Again.
Matt Bourne.
Born Again.
I never knew he was on the original WrestleMania, or it probably lost my mind because I rewatched it again recently. I was like, "What the hell, Matt Bourne on a wrestle? This is awesome!" Like, to me, WrestleMania 1, like Ricky Steamboat was on the first WrestleMania. Did you know that?
Yes, a lot of people were on there.
Like, did you notice like? Technically, WrestleMania 1...
Isn't it, like, really depressing now when you watch old-school WrestleManias? Like, half these people are dead now.
7's the worst for that.
Oh, my God, 7. Macho Man, Ultimate Warrior, Earthquake, Big Boss Man, who else? Legion of Doom, Animal.
Okay, so
Nasty Boys! No, not Nasty Boys. No, Axel Rotten was not on WrestleMania, never mind.
He could have been on 23. I'm thinking of Balls Mahoney, I guess. But what's your thoughts on Zack Ryder for just shooting?
Zack Ryder.
He's a good talent.
You know
he's
what?
A good head.
Yes, I agree. Zack Ryder is a talented guy. Really fucking talented. But his fucking gimmick pisses me the fuck off.
So you did not get into the whole Z True.
Oh, like oh, what does he do?
Woo woo
woo,
yeah.
Woo woo woo, fucking hell.
So like, he won the US title. Did you think
that was a joke, man? Like, he wasn't taken seriously.
Did you
know where was he most of the time? In a fucking wheelchair being shit upon.
I think he lost the title like Jack Swagger a couple weeks later or something.
Yeah.
But
he was in a program with John Cena that didn't go anywhere.
Did you not see Survivor Series 2011 where The Rock acknowledged the MSG audience chanting for We Want Ryder?
And
he's like, I want him too. But like, Zack Ryder,
if he was like treated differently and given him a different gimmick, I would like him again. But like, he's a talented guy, but I just can't take him seriously with his gimmick. Like, Bo Dallas. That dude's a talented motherfucker. Amazing.
Bo reminds me of Goofy.
Yes. He's amazing in NXT, but he has this Bo Leave gimmick, and I just want to strangle
Did
that
you
guy.
Know the joke about Bo? Why he had to change his tights, or what
character?
When he was wearing the white tights, they said he looked like Baby Huey, because he wore a diaper. You remember Baby Huey from the Casper cartoons?
Baby Huey. Oh, he was just missing a blue shirt and a bib.
He kind of did act like a baby, man.
Believe. Now he's in the Job Squad 2.0 with the other guys.
Axel, God, what happened to his push? Intercontinental. Oh, man, it pisses me off.
Curtis Angle. I was going to say Curtis Angle. Curtis Axel fucked himself over with like his promo on.
Yeah, Paul Heyman is his manager, man. He had nothing. He could have gone anywhere but up. Is it like what happened? Is it just typical?
I need to show you that video of him like when he was trying to do a promo and he just failed, and like it was like something about like I will destroy you and I will also destroy you. Keeps on saying destroy all so many times.
A lot of people find Bo or Curtis, from what I've heard, he's boring. He can't
cut Yeah, it's like that promo that he did, which I gotta show you, because it was hilarious.
So, he's talented, don't get me wrong.
Yes, he's talented.
Is it, so he doesn't have the same kind of mic talent.
Mic skills are not that good.
Mr. Perfect was awesome on the mic, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was. Then we got, what else do we have there? Like, Adam Rose, oh god, the Russell Brand 2.0.
Leo Kruger, man.
Leo Kruger, that was an insane gimmick, but...
You never saw it, though.
I saw one match or two, but that was really cool.
You remember last year when I
seen FCW when he was in there.
Was he just, when he was posting Leo Kruger pictures on Twitter, was he just screwing, trolling the...
I think he was, because like wrestlers like to do that sometimes. And who was the last... Oh, Heath Slater. I'm surprised he still has a job there, but I think
I say for anyone watching this, they should see that E360 NXT behind the scenes special that aired last year after WrestleMania.
That's a good one.
That opened my eyes. Adam Rose has a sick kid.
Is his heart outside his body or what?
Yeah, like that's some heavy something duty
like
stuff.
That. Like, I forget what it was, but is it something to do with his heart?
Yeah, it opened your eyes. Like, I was such a naive mark, and I. Should I explain the term for Mark? Fans that take the product way too seriously, basically.
They actually think it's real and believe everything they say. Like, the guys from Ready to Rumble, that movie. I love that movie because they're so fucking stupid.
Oh, yeah, that's kind of what they...
Yeah, but like, Marks are like the guys from Ready to Rumble. Like, they take this shit way too seriously. Wrestling's not fake!
But, yeah, I honestly thought Leo Kruger had a real... Like, he is from South Africa... But I thought he had the real thick South African accent. I thought that's how he really talked. But number one, I think his real name is like Matt or something. And he talks just like me or you and no accent whatsoever.
Keep on talking. I'm just going to see how many battery left I have.
Okay.
Yeah, it's still good.
That's good, man. So like that NXT E360 special, it's like the one on Scott Hall. Did you see that one?
Yeah. I'm surprised. I never heard of him like... killing a man in self-defense, that was brand new to me. Yeah, Scott Hall, before he was a wrestler, he killed a man in self-defense in a bar because the guy was drunk as fuck or something. And like,
I just love the old
wanted to kill Scott Hall and he killed
AWA
him in self-defense.
AWA photos of Scott Hall with the porn star mustache. And
yeah, the 80s was a funny time.
I still can't believe, like, everyone, obviously the fans of our generation know how screwed up WCW was, but you gotta... Remember, there's a lot of kids coming up that...
The PG era kids! Like, Mom, who's that guy?
For any of you that don't
did
know...
You remember, like, when Mr. Wonderful came out on Raw for, like...
No, I was going to say, the PG era fans know Kevin Nash is that guy that showed up in Powerbomb CM Punk and probably know his end up. There was a time, kids, where in WCW, he was known as Oz. He would come
and
to...
Vinny Vegas and Blade.
But Oz was the best. Coming to the ring as an old guy... Take off the robe and the wig, and you're this jacked up young guy with face paint. How fucked up is that?
Yeah. You didn't know this until I told this.
Yeah, yeah.
Because, like, the Master Blasters, Kevin Nash was, like, playing blackface. And I showed that to you.
Yeah,
I did not
know that.
For those of you who don't know, Kevin Nash was in a team called the Master Blasters. He was either called Blade or Steel.
Was that Kevin Green?
Al Green.
Or else...
Yeah.
But
yeah, look this up. The Master Blasters ECW. Kevin Nash is in blackface. I shit you not. It's on Google. Check it out.
I'm just going to get my phone for a minute.
But yeah, what were we talking about? Like, originally, Fastlane. The Triple Threat match. Wow, it took this long to come back to it. Okay.
Yeah, but that's what that's what YouTuber shoots are for. Just keep talking.
Just keep on going.
Sometimes it's more entertaining. You said, we all know Roman Reigns is obviously going to win. How excited are you for Triple H versus Roman Reigns at WrestleMania?
Not at all. Because it reminds me of Batista versus Randy Orton. Fuck, my phone. I'll call him back. Decline.
Okay. Well, that's what happens in everyday life. Stuff sometimes gets in the way. But
But yeah, like the Triple Threat.
How many years have they fucked this?
Roman Reigns is three times in a row now. Roman Reigns is gonna win this one because like Brock Lesnar's in this because like obviously the Wyatt family's gonna run in and interfere because they're gonna set up Brock Lesnar versus Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania.
Yeah, we all see that coming.
Dean Ambrose is just the punching guy to get his ass kicked in that match. And of course, Roman Reigns, obviously the person who's going to win it. What else is there on the card? Oh, yeah.
Kevin Owens and Dolph Ziggler for the IC title.
Kevin Owens is going to win that because, like, yeah, they're going to have Kevin Owens versus AJ Styles at WrestleMania.
Kalisto and Alberto Del Rio.
I don't know. That's on the pre-show, though, but still, okay.
It's still technically part of the Fastlane. Like, yeah. That's funny. Okay, yeah.
Kalisto versus Del Rio.
I'm going to say I guess Kalisto will retain it because they want to kind of maybe move Del Rio in a different direction.
Diddy Klein was message. Call you in 15 minutes. Send.
Okay.
Keep on talking, sorry.
Yeah.
This is how it happens. It's live.
It's live and mistakes can happen. Yeah. Shockmaster.
Shockmaster. But Kevin Owens versus AJ Styles and Mania.
Divas title, Charlotte and Brie.
Fucking Brie. No.
Do you care?
No, I don't. I say Charlotte wins. I don't want Brie to win because fuck the Bella Twins.
They're going to do a triple threat, I think, with Sasha and Becky Lynch and Charlotte and Mania.
That's going to be cool. If they do it right, because the Divas Revolution has been shit on the main roster. They do it awesomely.
How long are they going to call it the Divas Revolution? 10 years?
I have no idea, but man... The wrestling on NXT between the women is way better than the one on the main roster.
Bayley and Sasha Banks, my friend.
That was awesome, man. And they have a tag team match at Fastlane between the Divas. What is it? Naomi and Tanima versus...
Sasha and Becky. Obviously, it's going to be Becky and Sasha.
I don't care who wins that match, like, honestly.
Did you not hear Sasha's ovation at the Rumble? I brought that up to you.
Yeah, it was a good ovation. People went nuts.
I'm a Sasha Banks fan.
Yeah, I'll say Sasha and... Whoever is her tag team partner is will win.
I'm just trying to think what else there is. The title. They're gonna have a highlight reel with the New Day with Edge and Christian.
That's gonna be amazing.
Edge and Christian got a new show on the network.
Seeing Edge and Christian together is pretty awesome.
Is Christian's career done? Or
probably. Cause like
I think he's technically.
He hasn't officially retired, but he hasn't been wrestling lately.
I just don't think they know what else to do with Christian, but he's Edge's sidekick. But isn't it funny how wrestling comes full circle? They broke up, and now they're back together. Isn't that how it usually works?
Let me give a storyline on why they're back together. Like, unlike what they're called, the primetime players. Like, they broke up, and then they got back
together
for no reason.
There's also a six-man that nobody cares about. Braun Strowman.
Oh,
the White family versus Kane, Big Show, and... Ryback, that's another guy.
In the words of Jim Ross, this is going to be Bowling Shoe Ugly, folks.
Yeah.
It's going to be bad.
I
Braun Strowman, the White Mark Henry.
Yeah.
And Mark Henry says he's going to retire soon, which I don't give a fuck because I never enjoyed Mark Henry.
It's Black History Month. That's the time where they... these homage segments that they show these guys... Is that what they're intended to be so emotionally touching, where they just grip at your heart?
Yeah, because the WWE knows how to grip at your heart. God damn, look at the Dusty Rhodes Memorial thing.
Oh, obviously that, yeah. Shout out to Bret Hart, who had successful surgery a couple weeks ago. Great news to hear. I'm sure.
Yeah, Bret Hart, god damn, prostate cancer, god damn.
Great news to hear. Owen Hart not going in the Hall of Fame this year. They did the big DVD back at Christmas time for him, Are you surprised to hear that? Should we even care?
I'm surprised they did that because, obviously Vince McMahon doesn't give a fuck what Martha thinks because, I can see it on both sides, from Brett's side and Martha's side, because I can totally agree on why Martha doesn't want any of Owen's images on WWE because, basically he died on WWE's
So there's
turf.
A difference.
Like, fuck, your husband died in the thing there.
There's a difference between how Randy Savage died and Owen Hart, because why Randy went in the Hall of Fame was because the demand from the fan base was enough that we wanted him to see him in the Hall of Fame. Isn't it the same for Owen? Or when he died like Owen did, is that a difference?
For me, it's kind of different, because fuck, he died on your show on a stunt that went horribly wrong. And I can see Bret Hart's side on it, where he goes come on.
Owen
people
was a victim of the Monday Night
War. People want
War.
Owen to be in the Hall of Fame. I agree on both sides, but I agree with Marva and Brett.
Have you heard that Owen is a victim of circumstance? He died in the vein of the war.
Yeah.
So to speak.
He was. And he was on his way out, too, wasn't he?
He was going to be a fireman. Retired.
Yeah, he was going to retire.
Which is
depressing in itself, because this guy was going to retire.
He had a happy life to look forward to.
Yeah. Because the guy never wanted to be WWE champion. He didn't want that life.
And he was a family man. Deborah, they wanted to do him.
Yeah, he wanted to have an affair with Deborah, but Owen loved his wife way too much to do that.
And he didn't party either. He was clean, straight edge, to use the term from Punk.
The original CM Punk?
Yeah, he did not clean or drink or anything. He was as straight laced as they could come. You know, or you hear stories like Brett going out to the bars and picking up a different woman every night. Don't quote me on that, of course, but
I think Brett said that in his book, though.
Yeah. You know, it was the 1980s of wrestling. Everyone drank, I guess.
It was the rock and roll era of wrestling.
You ever hear the story how Vince took all the fishy moves of guys at the bars? And
who was it? The Warlord that did a move on him? And like Vince had this look on him. It's like, if I remember this in the morning, I'm going to still fire you.
Oh, that was the best. I don't... I know he took he basically took almost all the finishing holds. Alcohol induced.
In his drunken stupor.
Do you know who Vince idolized? Dr. Jerry Graham, I think? That black wrestler?
Which one?
Is Dr. Jerry Graham, does that ring a bell to you?
He's not black, though.
No. Well, anyways, there's this wrestler. My apologies for being politically incorrect. I think it's Dr. Jerry Graham. But the guy was kind of deranged. You probably never heard the stories of how he wanted to leave the hospital with his mother's dead body.
Are you talking about Dr. David Schultz?
Is that who maybe...
Is that the guy who punched out, what's his name on the news for saying, is wrestling fake and he punched him in the face?
One of those doctor guys who was kind of not all with it, and that's who Vince idolized. And as Jim Cornette was saying, could explain some of Vince's mental problems, because...
There's too many doctor wrestling gimmicks in the wrestling world.
Mr. Wrestling is the worst. I always hear Mr. Wrestling 2, Mr. Wrestling 6. I just don't get that, man. How many freaking Mr. Wrestlings are there?
You not heard of Villano Brothers? Villano 1, Villano 6.
I like the Villanos. They were cool.
They're pretty cool tag team. And then you got the Samoan SWAT team, number 1 and 2.
Did you know Andre wore a mask at one time?
Yes, what was it called? Giant Mask or something.
They had a big storyline. He was supposedly
Giant Machine. That's the name.
That was before he turned heel with Heenan.
I love how the storyline is how Bobby Heenan knew it was fucking Andre, and he would make fun of him. Was like, come on, Andre, I know it's you. And the Giant Machine would go no.
Did he actually talk? Oh, so it was
I think he talked. I don't know. I think he was talking, but every time they interviewed the Super Machines the Super Machines or something, because there was a Giant Machine, and obviously it's Andre because he's fucking huge. Bobby Heenan would interview him and was like, so, what about you, Andre? You know what? When Bobby Heenan dies, I'm going to fucking cry.
We all are, man.
Yeah, because, dude, I got my name from him. The humanoid part, because you know how he says humanoids and all that shit.
I suggest you don't go on Google and look at images of him present day. You all
he looks horrible, man. He looks horrible. But his 1992 commentary on Royal Rumble is fucking amazing.
Think of this. Once he passes on, you still say Monsoon and Heenan are the greatest trio?
Greatest commentators? Yeah.
Better than Ventura and Monsoon?
Gorilla and Bobby were the most awesome ones because they had good chemistry.
Well, Gorilla's gone now, but once Bobby's gone, they both will no longer be with us. Rest in peace to Gorilla right now, but just... You obviously that thought has probably crossed your mind.
Yeah, because everybody's dropping like flies now. Our generation's wrestlers, they're all just dying now.
Yeah, like I said in my video, NXT is a hidden gem of WWE, to quote Jimmy Corderas from Aftermath on CTV Sportsnet.
Jimmy Corderas is that referee guy.
Yeah. He's called NXT the hidden gem of the WWE.
It so is.
And just the talent coming out of there. Dash and Dawson, Gable and Jordan,
Gable and Jordan remind me of Team Angle with Shelton Benjamin and Charlie
Can you
Hawk.
See Gable having a singles run after him and Jordan have their tag run on the main roster?
Yeah, I guess they could. And like I said, they were thrown together too.
American Alpha, they're not known as. They actually have
Dash and Dawson, how you call them, the Brain Busters. Don't forget the Minnesota Wrecking Crew.
Yeah.
Same thing. Ole and Arn.
And it's the thing is, the funny thing about NXT is, Finn Balor is the face of NXT right now.
Yeah.
And he's in a dilemma where he's having such a great time in NXT that he's just, they all want to go to the main roster.
Yeah.
They do, but they don't, is what
Finn
it is.
Finn Balor even said, I don't want to go to the main roster because it's not going to work for me, but one day they'll call me up and shit.
I just personally think Vince, if he actually cared about the business, would fade off into the sunset and give creative control to Triple H.
That's going
to
happen only when Vince McMahon dies.
Like, do you know he has a home in Florida that he maybe visits like 2 months of the fucking year?
Vince McMahon has a lot of things, man. I wouldn't be surprised if he has an island somewhere.
Like, the guy does not... The guy can work, don't get me wrong, but, you know, there's a saying. If you had as much money as Vince does, would you want to enjoy that money a bit?
Yes, I would. I would like to enjoy that money.
Like, Vince probably hasn't taken a personal vacation in years.
Yeah, I don't think he's ever taken a vacation, because he says he doesn't like vacations. Hell, he doesn't like when he sneezes himself, because he can't control the goddamn sneeze.
I love the... Want to talk about Vince stories? What's your favorite Vince story?
Like,
behind the scenes, like...
Oh, how he never heard of Pirates of the Caribbean, and he's wondering why there was a good pirate. Paul Burchill, the good pirate. When Paul Burchill was, like, the pirate on... He's, like, wondering, why is Paul Burchill good? Isn't he supposed to be bad?
Didn't he swing to the ring, too?
Yeah, that was awesome. That was a stupid gimmick, but I enjoyed it so much.
Or how about...
And he's, like, going, like, why is there a good pirate? Pirates are bad. They go, like, sir, it's because of Pirates of the Caribbean. What's Pirates of the Caribbean?
Son
of a bitch.
I'm talking about when he met the Rock and Roll Express for the first time.
Shoes are made for walking.
He did not know... No, that's the Rockers.
You said the Rockers.
Rock and Roll Express.
Oh, Rock and Roll
Ricky
Express.
Ricky and Morton, yeah. One of the most well-known teams of all time from that era.
Yeah.
He did not know who the hell they were, like, or what they've done. Because Vince... many of you probably don't know this. Vince doesn't watch any products outside of his own. He lives in the...
He tells him, like, make me a package of these people and I'll watch it. Like a 5-minute package.
He asked me to do that for him, basically,
yeah.
Right?
It's like, how he did it was ECW. He's like, put me a package of what they're doing. And he shows 5 minutes of it. It's like, okay, I got the basic.
Did you actually know they're actually acknowledging that there is a WWE version of ECW? They're actually acknowledging that now on the program.
Where?
Like, Jack Swagger, I think. They said he was not the original champion. Or this Tommy Dreamer one. Remember when Tommy, they all came back with that run with the Wyatts at the end of last year?
Yeah.
They said Tommy Dreamer is the only man to have held both versions of the ECW title.
Oh, they're actually acknowledging that?
I was surprised
by that.
That's
pretty cool. Because, yeah, they were acknowledging that their ECW was the real ECW, which was
cool. Or that the title histories were the same.
It is the same. Because it's the same belt. Yeah. I just found that out.
Separate.
No, at first I thought it was separate, but it actually is the same title belt, which is sad. Yeah.
I thought Rhino had possession of the original one.
They bought the ECW and everything with it, because... If Rhino wouldn't give him the title, he would have gotten sued off the ass.
Oh, so what's the original
if
title?
Rhino has it. He was the last ECW champion.
Oh, so...
But it's not. It's property.
I thought Rhino still has it to this day, because...
No.
I remember him teasing it. Remember on TNA?
Remember, like, they didn't show a belt at all in that segment? He just showed a bag.
So he didn't have the title, actually?
No, it was just for segment sakes. But, yeah. No. Vince McMahon... owns ECW and everything that comes with it. So if Rhino didn't give him the belt, he would have been sued like to hell. So
I think the television title got lost or something, though.
But they kind of changed up the ECW belt, because you know how they like to change belts all the time.
Yeah, they made that stupid Star Wars one.
Yeah. But it is, sadly, it is the original ECW belt.
That pisses me off.
Because like you have names such as the Sandman, Snuka,
hell, Vince McMahon, hell,
and a bunch of other people. And then you got Bobby Lashley and Vince McMahon and Big Show.
When Snuka held it, it was Eastern
Championship. Eastern Champion. But still, it was under ECW.
Don the Rock.
For those of you who don't know, ECW was once called Eastern Championship Wrestling. Then later on, it became Extreme Championship Wrestling.
Oh, am I throwing out an OD? All right, my apologies.
Because, yeah, we're dealing with the PG era now. For those of you who are brand new, because they're thinking, like, what are you talking about? Vince McMahon did the original ECW. It was on Sci-Fi.
I actually knew... not to fault this kid, I was talking to a kid in Max from India, 19 years old. He never heard of the original ECW.
A lot of people haven't heard of it.
He's like, what's that?
It's way old.
I just didn't want to go into the time to educate him, but it certainly made me feel old. No,
yeah, because we're getting old. Yeah.
Think about like Sting at WrestleMania. There was a lot of...
kids not knowing who this
who's
was.
Who's this guy?
Like, Mom, who is this clown?
Who's this guy that looks like the... Yeah, like the Joker.
You know, like when you mentioned Sting, not kids not realizing... Like, back to what I was saying about Mr. Wonderful, like, when they had, like, that Raw homecoming thing, everybody came out from the old school Raw, like, too cool, like, from last 10 or so years, everybody knew who they were, all of a sudden Mr. Wonderful comes out, Not a peep from no one. Only a few people in the crowd even know who he was. Me and you, as soon as we saw him come out, we're like, holy shit, it's Mr. Wonderful. But then you see on Raw, silent.
Have you seen recent photos of Paul Orndorff?
Yes, he's really old. That's what I'm saying.
He's got that cowboy mustache.
Yeah, he doesn't look like how he is, but he's really old. But I'm saying, no one, the kids had no idea. It's like, Mom, who is this old guy coming out with a robe?
Well, let me ask you this. How many kids would know that Harley Race, to quote
no
you,
one.
Was an NWA god?
No one. No. Like, when Harley Race came out, they were saying, like, who is this fat guy?
Like, he did that. I think the last thing he did on WWE programming was when Randy Orton RKO'd him or whatever.
Probably. But that was before the PG era, though.
The Ruthless Aggression era.
Yeah, I love that era. That was
ruthless
a good era.
Aggression, I think. Yeah. That's before John Cena went all corporate and PG, right?
Yeah, Cena, though. Like, he was... Okay, I will admit, there was a time where John Cena was actually bearable and watchable and actually enjoyable. That's when he was before the corporate Super Cena thing. It all started at WrestleMania, what?
21?
21, when he won the belt. He was still kind of likable. But still, remember how it... Okay, I'm going to go on a rant about this, because like JBL, as much of a shit champion that he was...
Eddie Guerrero vouched for him, don't forget.
I know, I'm just saying, as much of a shit champion that he was... Through 7 months that he was champion, he defended that title and won. He cheated and shit, but he was 7 months, like, defeating all the odds.
Big Show in a bar.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He defeated all the odds. Kurt Angle, The Big Show, a bunch of other people, Fatal 4-Way. The Cabinet, fuck them. But yeah, you gotta admit, 7 months, he defeated them all, defied all the odds. Then John Cena comes along, beats him in 7 minutes.
I thought it was like 20 minutes.
No, it was 7, I think.
That's absolute shit, then.
Yeah, imagine that. Like, JBL, all this thing. I know
you had a turn match at Judgment Day a few months later.
Yeah, you did. But I gotta say, yeah, as much as I did not like JBL as a champion, he defended it for 7 months, defied all the odds, and then John Cena wins the tournament to become a contender. That's when the John Cena thing started happening, but he was still watching him. Then he wins in 7 minutes, which was just shit.
Hey, but
and then
you know,
after that is when the people
that
started
reminds me of the Ultimate Warrior.
No, I think it's the hate started when he turned the belt into a spinner belt. That's when we had enough of him.
Yeah, and the fact that he had like what 4 WrestleManias with the title or something.
Yeah,
like remember WrestleMania 22, old school versus new school? We all thought Hunter was going to be the saving grace.
Did you lose a bet with some fan about that?
I think I did. Yeah.
As you were saying, like, no, John Cena is going to lose, Triple H is going to win, and, like,
No, but was it just me that was hoping Hunter would win? And
no, we were all hoping that Triple H
would return the title back to its former glory.
All of us wanted Triple H to win. We thought Triple H was going to win, but then John Cena won, and it was like, we're like, what the fuck?
I'm thinking it was a Vince McMahon poll that changed the outcome. It was supposed to be Hunter. Was you?
Yeah.
But I think Vince changed it last minute, unless we were all mistaken.
I have no idea.
Did you know, though, that they were supposed to have a return match at WrestleMania 23 before Michaels got injured? Or the Michaels spot was supposed to be Hunter's before he got injured, remember?
Right. That Shawn Michaels.
Yeah,
man.
That was the only Mania that Hunter's missed in the last decade.
Oh, my gosh. Shawn Michaels' storyline with JBL is like he owns Shawn Michaels. Like,
oh, that was
Shawn Michaels is a rich motherfucker. And
Shawn was Virgil.
Yeah, that was horrible.
That was shitty booking. If we're winding, I don't know how much longer we have, but if we're, do you want to talk about stupidest storylines or favorite wrestling jobbers?
Let's talk about stupid storylines and we can end it there.
What's your favorite shampoo commercial?
I would say the shampoo commercial is always the dumbest one. The Katie Vick storyline was just fucking,
Hunter.
What's the word called?
Necrophilia?
No, not necrophilia, like, controversial. Yeah.
Yeah.
Goldust becoming a stutterer, like Tourette's syndrome.
He's doing that again with R-Truth.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Have you seen those segments?
No, I have not yet.
They're doing the Booker T Goldust thing again because, like, everything is recycled in wrestling. Hall of Fame. We know Sting's going in this year. Who else do you think's going
in? They already leaked that on the web because, like, somebody leaked it, like, earlier. Like, they have, like... people from Texas. Jacqueline is going to be in it.
They do one female a year. Not surprising.
Yeah. JBL, possibly.
Yeah,
you know what? I forget who was in this. Like, Sting, JBL, like...
They do one...
The Freebirds or some shit.
One person.
Vader. There's talk of Vader being in it this year.
That'd be awesome. I'd like to see that.
Yeah.
Freebirds, though, two-thirds of them are gone, so that would be their post... What's that word? Post-humanists or humanages or...
Post-humanists? I don't know.
I can't say that word if it, like, depends on me, but they have a format they follow each year for the Hall of Fame, basically.
Yeah.
But the funny thing is, what's the Hall of Fame? The Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame?
The Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame.
Isn't that decided, like, by a board of people? Like,
yeah, it is.
Where in WWE, it's so messed up, it's one person that decides it. Like, and if he doesn't like you, you won't go in.
Like, look how long it took is Macho Man in it or not?
Yeah.
Look how long it took Macho Man to get in that thing.
Adrian Adonis in it?
I have no idea. I think
I'd like to see him going.
There's a lot of people that need to be in there.
Rick Rude.
Yeah, Rick Rude. But, like, yeah. WWE's Hall of Fame is all political because it's a fucking joke and they all know it.
You think Daniel Bryan's going in this year?
Probably, because, like, hey, Edge retired and they put him in right away. And Daniel Bryan, he's bet you anything he's going to be put
when
in that
Eddie
last
minute. Eddie passed away, they put him in right away too, so.
Yeah.
And they want to...
Probably now they're going to have Chris Benoit. Oh, it's the word I should not ever say, but hell, I'm not WWE.
Chris
so
Benoit's
safe.
Son went on a rant on Twitter that you acknowledged before the Rumble, didn't he? Or
oh, yeah, like WWE not acknowledging that Chris Benoit was the longest lasting Rumble entrant. When you always say that Rey Mysterio is, which is not.
What was Benoit, 64 minutes?
64, 65. And Rey Mysterio was 62. But yeah, like, bet you anything, Chris Benoit will never be in Hall of Fame. Because imagine the fucking backlash if that happened. Like, they were promoting a murderer in there, but yet they. You know what?
Mike Tyson,
they,
right?
They have Mike Tyson in there, and he's a convicted rapist.
What's that story? Oh, he raped?
Yeah, he got a convicted rapist, went to jail, got out.
And he also ate another guy's ear.
Evander Holyfield. But yeah, how can you...
Oh,
like,
Regis Philbin's going in for the...
Oh, for fuck's sake. The Celebrity Hall of Fame.
Who's the worst...
Drew Carey. Drew Carey is the worst.
I thought that Mr. Baseball guy. Whatever.
At least he did something in baseball. It's like he did something in baseball.
Mike, Mr. T's speech was the best.
Oh, Mr. T was the best speech ever. He just went on, like, he just kept on going about his mother and all that stuff. Like, my mother did this. Kane had to come out to, like, shut him up. It's like, come on, man, you gotta get out. It's over already.
And we're still joking about it 2 years later.
Yeah.
What's the best Hall of Fame speech you've probably seen? Ric Flair's?
Ric Flair's, Bobby Heenan's,
What did Bobby Heenan talk about? I never really saw
he
that.
He went on a... This was before they had, like, time limits.
Is a lot of these on YouTube, if I...
Yeah. Because, like, there was a... When the couple of first four Hall of Fames were, like...
Did you ever see the ones from, like, the 90s where they...
I like the original ones where they just let them talk.
Yeah.
Now you got, like, 5-minute time limit.
But is it just me, or is the Hall of Fame just deployed to boost WrestleMania ticket sales?
Yeah, it is.
Because there was a time in the 90s when the Hall of Fame inductions were more legitimate. Like, when they would hold them sporadically at any time of the year. That's when I liked them better, personally. But, you know, technically... Every year, I guess, at WrestleMania kind of makes sense, right?
Yeah.
And then you got that stupid Access, which...
That show, my God.
As you would say, it's for the marks, but...
I wouldn't mind going to it, but seeing just a bunch of guys with their wrestling
belts... I know what we should talk about. Kurt Angle is going to be at the Arnold Sports Show to get inducted into the Arnold Hall of Fame. And me and you talked about this a lot privately. And you were pretty adamant that Kurt's not going to be returning to the WWE anytime soon.
Yeah, because, like, when he first was there, before he left, he was on suicide watch because of all the bullshit he did. And they had to let him go because, like, he was way out
there.
And
he's still it's openly acknowledged within the wrestling community that Kurt Angle still has a drug problem.
Yeah, and, like, WWE is not going to hire him back because at this point he's too much of a liability for him. But WWE signs Jeff Hardy over and over all the time, and he's like a major drug addict.
Yeah.
But when Kurt Angle beats Jeff Hardy and all that shit, you know that's fucked up.
Especially when you hear stories at WrestleCon, him being high on crack or cocaine.
Yeah.
Just slurring his speech, you know. You know, right
WWE
there,
does not want Kurt Angle to die on their watch.
So they actually don't really care about Kurt. It's more about them
it's
having
too much of a liability for them now because
that's
like
bullshit,
a public...
man.
Yeah,
I'm sorry to say that.
I know. It is.
I'm just realizing I'm sometimes so oblivious to stuff. Like, They don't care about Kurt Angle, the person. It's the fact that he would die and they would be held accountable.
Yeah,
it's bullshit.
Exactly.
Pardon my language, but you probably knew this all along. I'm so out of it sometimes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, and you thought Kurt Angle was going to get hired back because him and Triple H are in the same room.
No, that means nothing, I guess.
Yeah,
no, really. Actually, isn't it kind of acknowledged that him and Hunter don't really get
along? I forget what's going on with that. They used to have beef. I don't know how they are now, but they had major beef back in the day.
How about Rey Mysterio? You think he's coming back?
I hear he wants to come back, but honestly, I don't want him to come back because every time he comes back to the WWE, he gets injured after injury after injury.
So you're under the impression that his body could not handle a full-time
schedule. Well, on a WWE schedule, because if he's doing part-time, because he's independent, Lucha Underground, he's doing fine. But now he's in a full-time
Like, me and you, we're in our early 30s now, right? He's got to be getting close to 40, I imagine, right, Mysterio?
Probably, yeah.
He's not the same kid. Like, what would you say is Rey's greatest match? The Halloween Havoc with Eddie Guerrero?
That's one. Title versus mask? Yeah, that'd be a good one.
That's the one I
really. Anyone was Eddie Guerrero.
That's storyline.
Match was Kurt Angle.
That time with Dominic was so. They had awesome, like, I think a 2 out of 3 falls match on SmackDown or something. I was recently watching that again, and Eddie has his back all bruised up from Rey hitting him with the chair. And
remember when they first brought him in, like, they called Rey Mysterio, Edge, and John Cena the future of SmackDown.
The one thing I noticed is WCW, they call him Rey Mysterio Jr. Did he get permission from his uncle to drop the Jr. from his name or something? I think I heard.
No, because like WWE, Vince McMahon doesn't like the name Jr. That's why they never have Junior
in there. Some people always call him Vince Junior.
That's why anybody with the name Junior in there. That's
Chavo Guerrero Junior. Yeah.
Chavo Guerrero, Rey Mysterio, Kurt as what? Kurt Hennig Junior? No. Uh-huh. That's not his name. Rey Gordy Junior. Because Rey Gordy, but he was a different name.
Yeah, he was Jimmy.
Festus? Or, no, Jesse.
Jesse. It's been so freaking long. Yeah, they were. Biscuits and gravy.
I think we're dabbling on too long, and we gotta go watch the PWA show.
Yeah. Let's cut it off.
Yeah,
it's been a great talk.
So, anyways, this is Jason, and I'm Humanoid and all that stuff. Check out his channel. I'll link his channel down below and shit. Anyways, take it easy, guys. Humanoid freak out. Bye.